Okay, the Baltimore Police Department today is going to announce that we're going to create an initiative to stop these illegal dirt bikes that are terrorizing our city streets. Time and time again, our citizens are complaining that these dirt bikes riding around throughout the city are terrorizing vehicle traffic and pedestrian traffic, and it's causing a big issue for our city. So we've taken a proactive stance on these dirt bikes. We created and we're going to create, and we have created an email where citizens can anonymously send us information as to where people are storing these illegal dirt bikes. The email is dirtbikes@baltimorepolice.org. We're going to be working in conjunction with our regional order task force team to look through these complaints and investigate some of these issues and some of these complaints where they're storing these illegal dirt bikes. Primarily, we're going to be trying to seize these dirt bikes. We're going to continue to investigate, and hopefully we're going to deter some of these individuals that are illegally riding these dirt bikes in the city. Any questions?
Did you say you're not a new task force? He's just going to start.
That's correct. That's correct. The Regional Order Task Force has been in existence. They're working primarily with stolen autos, but they're also going to help us in this initiative to look into these dirt bikes.
We found that 29% roughly of the dirt bikes. I'm sorry. We found that 29% of the dirt bikes that are out there right now on the street are stolen. That's just based on the statistical data that we've retained in recovering the dirt bikes that are on the street. It is illegal to ride them on the street, so once the dirt bikes are taken off the street, they're taken down to the city yard, and at that point, if the owner shows up with proper documentation, then the bike is legally returned to them. If they don't have proper documentation, they're not getting the bike back. So you have to prove ownership when the bike comes in.
Isn't it illegal to even have them in the city unless they're disabled, or what is the exact law?
Well, you're not allowed to have them in a house or a shed filled with gasoline, things like that. It's in violation of a fire code at that point. Obviously, you're not allowed to ride them on the street either. Obviously, if someone's traveling through the city, they have it on a trailer and it everything's looks legal, then, you know, we're fine with that. But as you know, it's time again, you know, innocent people are hurt by these things. And they knowingly break the law. I mean, we all see it. You all have filmed it. We have filmed it. We've seen what's going on. It's all over YouTube. And it's a danger to the city. And, you know, the citizens are actually asking that something be done about it. And we're trying to do the best that we can in an effort to contact the citizens. That's why we've set up this this email where we can actually
I think primarily it's taking a proactive stance. If people don't have access to an email, they can always refer back to 911 and call anonymously and give us those tips. We're looking for tips. We want to take a proactive stance. It's better to do something than do nothing. And actually, this is going to help. You're going to see a difference. People's going to take action. People are going to take charge of their communities, and that's what we want. We want them to take charge of their communities and give us the information that we need to put these individuals behind bars and to confiscate their illegal dirt bikes.
How important is the reporting? I know you guys had a few big busts, but we saw a lot of them. And it seems like without the public's help, you kind of really need them to tell me where these bikes are in neighborhoods. So I guess how important is it that they report it?
It's important because the way they ride is a danger to the public. I mean, it's pretty obvious as to, you know, what it is. And, you know, I'll be honest, a lot of these riders, they're looking for the attention. That's why they're on YouTube. That's why they're doing the things that they do. And they're looking for the attention for the police to try to pursue them. You know, and our pursuit policies prevent us from doing that. They know it. So, you know, we have to take a different approach in order to try to effectively prevent what they're doing.
Are there certain parts of the city where it's a particular problem?
Yeah, we have a section up off of Reisterstown Road right next to Jewett Hill Park. As a matter of fact, we've taken some proactive efforts to try to keep them from riding there and try to keep the public from viewing them. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and that's another problem that we've had is the public actually sits on the side of the hill and watches them. So they have an audience. You know, I mean, it's a legitimate audience that they have, but that's not the only thing that they're trying to get. They're just trying, you know, get their name out there.
When you say sits on the side of the hill, you mean like in Druid Hill Park?
Oh yeah, right. There's a section of the park where there's a hill that just faces right down the side of Reisterstown Road, and you can sit there and watch these guys do their thing. So we've done a few things to try to prevent them from doing that.
Once again, the email is dirtbikes@baltimorepolice.org. dirtbikes@baltimorepolice.org. And we're going to be issuing these postcards through all communities. We're going to be handing them out in community meetings. We're going to put them out in mailboxes and so forth. We want to put this out there so our citizens can stay proactive with us to help us get rid of some of these bikes.
Major, are there any incidents that you can recall that, you know, I mean, it's one thing to say that they're terrorizing, obviously, but are there any violent incidents or accidents that have cost lives or things like that you can remember?
Just most recently, we've had a shooting right off of Drew Hill Avenue or Drew Hill Park involving dirt bikes. So there is some violence attached to these rioters, and not all the time, but we do have issues where we've had shootings and or homicides related to these dirt bikes. So it's all the way around. It's a menace, and we have to take some type of action.
One more question. So you auction them off after you confiscate them? Do they come back to the community? Do people just buy them?
No. The city has a legal process in place to when we confiscate a dirt bike. It goes through a legal process. If you're not a titled owner, the main thing is we try to find out who the owner of the bike is. A lot of times these bikes are stolen. So the legal process is that if you don't have a title or some type of a paperwork associated with the dirt bike, then the bikes get destroyed. They're never resold. The only way you can get a bike back is by being a rightful owner.
All right, thanks. We'll get you guys the specific.
No.
We'll get you guys the specific press conference. Work with me here, Brian. I'm going to give you specific information on the program, how it's going to work.
Thank you, guys.
You are watching BPD-TV.